Select your hero.
Hey folks, Hammy here. Hope all is well and good, and we are jumping into the Year of the Rooster Brawl. It is none other than Capture the Rooster to some, Capture the Flag to others, and oh boy, what are we going to go for here? So many decisions. I'm quite surprised that no one has gone for the Cult of Torbjorn. So I'm going to jump in as the Cult of Torbjorn, but maybe if I can get a few games, we will certainly try and check out a few different heroes. So this is 6v6. I believe that all abilities are in play. There's actually been a developer update. You should, after you've watched this or after you've watched my skins and all collectibles and unlockables video as well, do go and check that out. But the developer update, oh wow, it's a new haul. Look at this. Very, very awesome. So when we saw where D.Va was in her...
Hello, hello. In her little trailer
for the Year of the Rooster trailer. This is a new room. I wonder where this is. And it's probably a tweak to the map as well. Look, we've got the roosters on the walls. We've got red lucky pockets there. Maybe a little bit of money. Okay, so let's have a look at this new layout of the map. Okay, so, interesting. So this is kind of a revamped version of the spawn of Lijiang. But instead of the dropship, we've got this kind of area instead. This building, I believe, is kind of the same. Yeah, this is all Lijiang, but it's just a revamped front area. Now look at this, isn't this interesting? Can I get up here? I certainly can. Okay, so I'm going on defense, so I'm going to get my turret straight up and see what's going on. There we go. Genji over the top. Okay, so our defense seems to be... There we go, teammate taking the flag. We've got two from the left-hand side. I'm going to try and keep this turret up. Oh, so much chaos. Okay, we managed to hang on. The enemy team returned. Oh, this is looking so cool. I'm absolutely loving this mode already. So, a few little UI changes you can see there in the top. You can actually see that... The flag and its position, relatively speaking, are all shown on that top piece there, which is pretty cool. So this is a very, very vulnerable place for sentry. We can see you've kind of got a bit of a sentry gun pit here. You've got a bit of a defensive pit here set up around this flag, and that's going to be a nice way. But you've got already saw the 76, already saw the Genji flanking from the left-hand side. So loving the look of this so far. So you are going to need a split between offense and defense. Remember, this is 6v6. No heroes are out of bounds. So it's going to be interesting to see how this goes. There is our rooster-style flag. So the real question is, how is our offense going to adapt? And how is the offense going to be able to get in? It's going to require a lot more coordination. They have a bastion on their points. Okay, nicely done. I'm actually going to get away from my... Okay, looks like our defense is going on. Our defense is going on. Okay, oh! Oh, far over the top. Okay, right. While we're in the death rays, I'm going to need to get some comms going so we can actually hear what's going on. Comms. There we go. Please tell me I actually set that rather than just leaving it. That would be rather embarrassing. Comms. Press to talk is now left control. Hey team, how's it going?
Hello.
Alright. So yeah, loving the look of this new area, very festive, got all of the fireworks and things. We've got Mercy and Pharah around our point. The Mercy's top right, the Pharah's up in the air above our flag. Okay, so hit scan going to be good. We can see that Mercy and Pharah are trying to team up here. Okay, I'm going to just get a turret in position.
I foresee great things.
Something in the air.
Justice reigns from above!
Yeah.
Oh boy. Where's the flag gone?
Get them off the point.
Oh no.
The enemy has captured.
Oh wow, that was a quick cap.
Score. 0-1.
Wow, okay. So there we go. Look at these. I think these are new. Different ways of getting over the top. So a few nice little tweaks to the map here.
Get on the point.
Okay, so my old Cult of Torbjorn has not really helped too much there so far. Okay, where could be a good point? I think actually in the pit could be a good point. We've got a nice little point of cover here.
Understood.
Right, okay, so I'll get this in position, then we'll go offensive Torbjorn. And 1-0 down so far. So lots of new sort of attacking routes opened, a little bit of a boost to get people over. We saw the Pharah and Mercy working pretty nicely there. Back to my Team Fortress Classic days. You probably have a set amount of people on offense, a set amount of people on defense, but that's kind of the same with any Capture the Flag layout. So I could be defense, I'm going to flex, I'm going to pop offense, see what we can do. Come on, mate. Oh dear, embarrassing. Yeah, it can be pretty dangerous as a Torb. Alright. What's going on? Yeah, Bastion's top right on their flag point. Yeah, he's on the top right hand side. Okay, so. Go on, Morphin Core. Go on, turret. Do something. Oh, a little bit of a waste there. Okay, so I'm going to go flank top right. Oh, we've got their flag. Oh, so close. Have we? Haven't we? Go on, guys.
Attack the objective.
So, of course, mid-control is going to be a big thing here. And good comms, of course. You want to call people coming in. Now, how can I get up top? Not this way, that's for sure. Tracer incoming right hand side. So yeah, obviously the tracers, as Jeff said in the dev update, just trying to recall straight out of there.
Armor, come get it. Come get your armor.
Alright. I'm gonna get up high.
I feel great.
See, they've got one flag, so they can almost just sit still. Unless we get ourselves upstairs pretty fast. There we go, there's the Widow mine. Hello, Widow. I know you're here.
60 seconds.
Genji. Genji needs healing. Oh, that wasn't good. So much pain. Okay, I'm going to switch away from Torbjorn next time. I think I'm going to go for a little bit of offense. Let's see if we can do something a little bit more meaningful here.
Protect my turret!
So at the moment, the enemy team has just locked itself down. We need to make sure we get in there a bit more.
30 seconds remaining.
Hayden, stop me!
Don't let him know!
It's just a scratch.
Go on, get in there. Need the flag. Of course, grouping would always be good.
10 seconds remaining.
Just a little longer! Keep up our defense!
Tracers in right hand side.
They're taking the point. Time to get
through. Justice rains from above.
No. Oh no. Defeat. The Cult of Torbjorn. Oh, 9 eliminations. Oh boy. No, everyone's showing off their flashy skins already. What? You're not even serious. How did I get play of the game? What was going on? Oh boy. How did this happen?
Justice reigns from above.
I only got one. I killed one person. Boy. That was not a game. That was not a thing. How did that even work? I don't know. Okay, I think we need another game to redeem ourselves. Let's hope that this ticks over in 14 seconds and just dumps us straight into a new game so we can give it a go the other way. So initial impressions, not loads of coordination between our team there, but it was certainly a lot of fun, and I was certainly enjoying that in terms of, you could see the offense going on, you could see the defense going on, you could see it swinging both ways.
Now arriving at
Nijan Control Center. Okay. Are we actually going to see three different CTFs? Is it all Li Jiang Tao? That'd be interesting. Righty, so who am I going to be if I'm on offense? No one has tried Sombra. Everyone has sort of discussed, oh, Sombra's going to be an OP this mode. I think this is the time that we need to give her a go and see what exactly she is made of. It's going to be pretty interesting, I think. Okay. Righty, let's jump on in. So Sombra, got a lot of offensive ability, going to be jumping around. We've got Symmetra there, we've got a little bit of Junkrat, so we've got some good defense. I'm just going to play total offense here and see if I can get in there. I am not a good Sombra. I'm really not a good Tracer, but Tracer could be good. We saw Tracer in the other game with Recall jumping in being clinically effective. And as I was saying in the dev update, we saw Jeff Kaplan saying that when they were using... So we've got Control Center as well. And notice that this is the new spawn in all cases. Now we've got a few little lucky pockets, a few bows, a few bit of bits of fruit. Nice little sort of a celebration style thing here. Okay, so allow me to remember, Sombra should be awesome. Here. We've got Cloak, we've got Translocate. I throw in my Translocate, pick the flag, run away. If I can get that working, that should be very, very good indeed. We need to defend our flag, we need to capture theirs. Okay, so they're both actually within the control center by the looks of things. It's going to be very, very interesting. We've got D.Va and another on the left-hand side.
Be right back.
Right, okay, so it's going to be real close in here, full on defense. Interesting actually to see for a capture the flag map, whether, like Control, they play sort of a couple of rounds, a couple of short rounds over a few maps like it would be on a Control map. So like maybe you'd have to win 2 out of 3, you'd have to win a set amount of rounds, like for King of the Hill, but on one map in different areas, that'd be pretty interesting. Right, so seems like it might be kind of hard. Maybe I'm going to need to go for a heavier approach here than Sombra, but we'll see. I need to just get myself an idea of where the actual flag is first. That'd be pretty good. Okay, I'm going to be able to drop down here. Right, so this could be pretty fun. Beacon. If I can get this one, I've got 15 seconds. So if I can get myself around the back, that'd be pretty cool. Okay, let's do that. Right, how do I actually grab the flag? Come on. Okay, that's not going to work. Bastion set up at the back, just looking straight down to the point. So there's a little flag capture time. I've got to press a button or something. I've not actually found that out yet.
Reboot and try again.
But what I'll do is Sombra around the back and get that Bastion, I think. We'll see how we can go first. Okay. Get around the outside. My responsibility is to get rid of that Bastion to start with. Oh boy. Everyone leaving.
Teleporter online.
Where's the Bastion? Where is the Bastion?
Here I am.
Oh boy, not so good.
Your team has the flag.
Oh, we got it because everyone left. Okay, go on, let's guard the hog back.
I will shield you.
Okay, I'm taking it. Ooh, look at that, we got a score.
Okay. Score. 1-0. My teleporter is under attack. My teleporter has been destroyed. The path is closed.
We gotta push it back. Ahorita regreso. Feeling much better.
Okay, let's see if I can get myself stealthed in here.
Your team has the flag.
Come on. Looking for
everyone
me?
On the point.
Oh boy. They've got our flag. Which way is it coming? Around the outside. I'm here in a nice little defensive position. Oh no!
The objective is under attack.
Where's the flag? Oh, it takes me a while to get. Can I?
Apagando las luces.
Can I use my translocator?
Teleporter
online. Yes, I can! Oh, I can translocate with the flag! So balanced. Oh, come on, guys! Come on, guys! I'm just standing there. Help me! That was my glory cap. That was my moment. Am I actually doing something as Sombra? Oh, look at that victory! Loving it. Good stuff. How bad can you be? Oh boy, am I?
Play of the
Okay, so Sombra, we see that stealthing didn't really do anything, I think, but we could of course translocate with the flag, and we've seen blinks with the flag as well. So of course trace anything with movements, Pharah with the flag, that'd be interesting. Maybe we should go Pharah, try cap next time. We saw the pharmacy doing a little bit of work on that occasion. Okay, I think we'll grab one more game, and we will finally try a different hero and see how it works out. Maybe perhaps also see the third map as well. That'll be a bunch of fun. So initial impressions of this mode, I would really, really love to sort of jump in, see sort of, I've not watched the full dev update yet. You should go to the Player Watch channel, watch that. Jeff talks about meta and things like that. This is a real opportunity, by the way, to if you enjoy this mode, to see if we can get this into Overwatch, to see if we can support the dev team, give lots of feedback, and try and get it into Overwatch as a full-time thing. So if you're really loving the look of this, then do see what you think. Do make sure that you post in the official forums and things like that. Give lots of constructive suggestions. This is a mode I'd love to see in-game. So let's have a think about movement-based heroes. Winston, we've seen, could be pretty brutal in terms of jumping in, getting a flag and jumping out. Anything that does point control could be pretty good. Sombra we saw there, I don't play her very well, but she certainly could be an interesting option. So I'm going to give Winston a final go and a few more movement-based heroes. When I used to play Team Fortress Classic, you had kind of a mode of three attack and three defense almost, or it could be four attack and two defense. You sometimes had even 8v8s, it was four attack and four defense. It was all sort of depending on the map. In fact, sorry, I think I'm remembering wrong. I think it was more of an 8v8 in terms of the clan stuff I used to play. So obviously with 6v6, I guess you could split into three attack, three defense, depending on the skill of your players, depending on the map. We're going to have a look. Is this... what have we got here? Okay, we are going to Night Market. So we'll actually have seen all three of the different maps, which is pretty cool. Well, in fact, did we see Night Market the first time around? Maybe we haven't seen Garden. Okay, let's have a look. Yeah, we saw this last time. Okay, Winston's going to be a good choice. I've got, of course, my jump pack. I can jump back in, jump back out. Throw down a shield. Going to be a good option there for flag grabbing. Put myself up here. Cheers, mate. Oh, I'm going to get out of there. My jump pack ready. Can I jump on in? I certainly can. Oh no, please don't tell me that was the Symmetra turret, wasn't it? It was. How embarrassing. Look at that. Oh look, it was just stepping 2 steps too close to that turret.
Once more onto the breach.
Have we got us? Have they got us? Oh no, what?
The enemy has captured.
What? How can you let D.Va in?
Enemy.
Oh, come on, guys.
One.
It's at this point that I noticed that I've turned off my music. Yeah, you did that, mate.
Let us welcome our guests.
Roadhog and Mercy incoming center. I'm going to go around the back. I'm going to get this Symmetra out of the way. Because I know there's two turrets here. Healed by Mercy. There's a Mercy and a Symmetra just sitting on their point. Gonna need some help. Oof. Winston is just a big meatbag in that situation. Just a big meatbag at their points.
The enemy has taken your flag.
Come on! I need some help. Tracer's running away with our flag left hand side. Oh, I got a spray. Ah, that's how you get that spray. Clean up duty. Awesome. Managed to get that flag back there. Now, Miss Symmetra is going to get play of the game just by eating all of my hit points. Okay. Got a monkey business. Ooh, can I take the flag with monkey business active? That would be good. You know, the reduced jump cooldown. We saw Winston in that trailer for a reason, I think. If one person can come with me, I've got ult ready, so we can get rid of the Symmetra nest. That would be awesome. Come on. There's also a shield generator over on the left-hand side of their point. So we need to get the shield generator in the bottom left of their pit.
That's bad.
Aye, aye.
Widowmaker and Mercy are holding the top center. How much closer could I be to get rid of that shield generator? Top tip, guys, people still don't twig that Symmetra's shield generator is a good thing to kill if it is set up. Pro tip! I'm not a pro, but that is a pro tip. I'm just gonna have a casual Chinese meal. Working hard as Winston.
Barrier activated.
Oh, good work. Oh, Widowmaker. Finally decided to get that Widowmaker in happy days. It's the tale of Winston. It's one monkey effort. Oh my goodness, shield generator, help the flag, we need it. Help the flag, everyone to the flag, come on. Everyone to the flag. I have no idea how you did that. Good job, Sombra. Fair play, Sombra. There we go. It wasn't the tale of Winston and his one monkey mission. I know, I'm gonna trigger it. Like, they don't care about the shield generator. Sombra just walks in. Right. Someone's got Trace already. I need someone with explodey and movement-based abilities. What better to go for the last minute of this than a Pharah, and see if we can deal with the Pharah. But get the flag. Jump jet away. 60 seconds. We've got one incoming to our flag from center. Do that if you want, mate. Roadhog incoming, bottom right. Oh boy. Yeah, Roadhog, they're incoming. Just defend to start with. Is that a pro widow? Oh, don't like this. Too many people dying. Let's keep the Bastion alive. Yeah, defend to start with. Clear the point. Three incoming, center, soldier on there. Anything that moves fast. Quick, anything that moves fast. Anything
I've got you in my sights.
Oh, could have got him then. Could have got him. Have they got our flag?
Converge on the objective.
Flag. Good job, Genji. Oh, draw. There we go. Oh, well, there we go. You win some, you lose some. You draw some. We still got our little highlights anyway.
Play of the game.
Oh, Widow coming through. Ouch. Nice. Okay, so there is a little flavour of some Capture the Flag there. Really enjoying that. I can't wait to, when people get a bit more used to it, people start grouping up, playing that as a team, seeing what metas come in. Three defense, three offense. Do go have a look at the Overwatch Developer update. I'm going to link that at the end of this. I need to watch the rest of it as well myself. Overwatch has been looking at a Capture the Flag mode for quite some time. So it's good to see it here, and let's get behind it. Let's absolutely give some good feedback on it. Play it a lot as the Brawl, and who knows what could happen. But really, really fun. I've genuinely really, really enjoyed that. Thanks so much for tuning into this video. Do have a look at my complete look at all of the unlockables, the skins, the voice lines, the highlight intros, and I'm going to do an unboxing video as well of a bunch of crates, so you can see that on this channel as well. But have a look at my full video of everything going on. If you want to have a look at the lore behind the Journey to the West skins, the ones for Zenyatta, Roadhog, Winston and Reinhardt, do have a look at the video in the bottom right here, and all of my usual Overwatch lore, story and news as well. Playlists here. Cheers for tuning in. I've been Hammy. Do let me know what you think of this mode in the comments below. Take it easy.